And monkey in the coconut tree.
Now, deep down in the jungles where the coconuts grow, lives a signifying monkey that the world should know. He told Mr. Lion one bright and sunny day, he said, "There's a big burly elephant coming down your way." Now, I know Mr. Lion, he couldn't possibly be your friend, 'cause he talked about the shape that your family was in. Now, you know, he talked about your mother and even your sister too. Man, he shook his fist at your daddy, and man, that big cat flew. Now, Mr. Lion, listen on. Man, he got sore. He popped that long bushy tail like a 44. He went on off down through the jungle with a terrific breeze, knocking coconuts from coconut trees.
Well, just as far as the eye could see, was a signifying monkey in the coconut tree.
Now on down through the jungle, who did he see? But that big old burly elephant propped up against a coconut tree. He said, "Uh-huh, it's plain to see that you're the big cat what's been talking about me." Now the elephant, he sort of looked at him out of the corner of his eye, see. He said, "You better go on, you big woolly rascal, and pick on somebody your own size." But Mr. Lion squared his shoulders and he made a pass. Man, you know that elephant knocked him right flat on the grass. Now you know, man, he messed up his ears, he messed up his face. Man, he threw that cat's shoulder bone all out of place. Now they fought all night, they fought all day. You know, I don't know how that cat ever got away.
Well, just as far as the eye could see, was a signifying monkey in the coconut tree.
Well, now, on down through the jungle, now who did he see? Nobody but that signifying monkey sitting up in that coconut tree. That monkey said to Mr. Lion, "Now you know it's a terrible shame. Yesterday you was the king of the jungle, today you look so tame." But that lion said, "Mr. Monkey, you know it's a shame that I can't climb, 'cause if I could, your head bone would surely be mine." And then the monkey, he got frantic and started jumping up and down. When all 4 feet slipped, man, his head sure hit the ground. Like a bolt of lightning and a barrel of white heat, man, that lion got on that monkey with all 4 feet. But then that monkey, you know, he looked up with tears in his eyes. He said, "Now, Mr. Lion, now wait a minute, I want to apologize." He said, "If you'll just let me up, like a good man should," he said, "you know, I'll whip your head all over these woods." About time the lion was putting up a pretty good fight. The monkey jumped almost out of sight.
Well, just as far as the eye could see, was a signifying monkey in the coconut tree.